Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. In this video, I will explain the tutorial how to set up the ABSS Premier for the new company. ABSS Premier is accounting application for small and medium companies. To start utilizing the application, I will show you how to open the application. You can go to the Windows and then try to find the ABSS that you already installed before. I installed the ABSS Premier International version 20. The content that we will discuss in this video, the first is the steps of ABSS Premier itself, creating the new company accounting data, set up company information, set up the preference, assigning jobs, dividing the categories, setting tax codes, explanation of transaction term, backup accounting data, restore accounting data backup. Now, this is the case. Now you want to create one company file. I want to use PTC here. So now I will input PTC information in this application. Just create a new company file. And then next. Okay, now type the company's name. The company's name is PTC. Then other important information in this form, you can type it if you have the information. Let's see the case. The case asks us to input the address by typing the name or your address maybe. Indonesia, just type Indonesia. And then next. After that, user has to set up the financial fiscal year of the company by determining the beginning and the ending of financial month. So you can just start the current financial year. For example, the company just start from last year, 2021. And the last month of the financial year, we can see the case, it's July to June. So June is the last month here. And the conversion month is the conversion month is the month in which you choose to begin entering the transaction. So according to the case, it's July, right? The number of accounting periods of the company, whether it is 12 or 13. Usually 13 is for adjustment entry. In our case, it's 13. So we just 13. Next. Double confirm, because the financial fiscal year cannot be changed once the company file has been created. If you want to change it now. Next, we can build the account list in ABSS Overs. ABSS provides three ways to create account list. First, I would like to start with one of the lists provided by ABSS Premier. Means that the ABSS Premier actually already provide us many type of companies and many type of account lists according to the companies. Let's see. After choosing the first one, next, and then here, there are some options here. For the industry classification, we have agriculture classification, manufacturing, retail, service, and other. And the type of business of the service, for example, there are some options. Accounting firm, advertising agency, advocate, and etc. You can choose one of them. For example, the accounting firm. And the account list will be adjusted. It depends on the type of business. For example, here, the expenses, accounting and audit fees. Why? Because the type of business is accounting firm. Okay, let's back. The second choice is, I would like to import a list of accounts from provided by my accountant after I'm done creating my company file. And the last, I would like to build my own accounts list once I begin using IBSS Premier. All right, next. After done everything, we save the company's file by choosing the folder in computer. Make sure that the folder is saved and to save our file. Change it. Usually I use D and I already have the folder PTC. Just use this one. And then I will save it by naming it PTC Original. All right. So next. And just choose Command Center. Here you go. In this video, I will show you how to create and modify categories, tax codes, and jobs. First, the category. We have four categories here, the category ID and the category name. Okay, let's open the application. The category is in the list menu, and then we choose categories. The function of this form is categorize the type of businesses, or, for instance, the company has some brands for its product type. Okay, and then we need to categorize that brand here. To add the new category, just click the new button here and then type the category ID here. What is the category ID? The category ID is JKT. And the name is Jakarta Area. Let's click new to enter the next new category. Sum for Sumatra Area and etc. You can type it. If you want to edit the category name, choose first the category that you want to edit and then click edit or click the arrow button. All right. And if you want to delete the category from the list, you can open one of it and click your mouse on the right and delete it. Example like this. Click to open it and then click right on your mouse and delete. All right, example like this. So it's disappear. Okay, that's enough for the category. It's easy, right? Next, the second tax codes. Okay, we can go to the list and choose tax codes. The function of this form is to create master database of tax and make it linked to the account list when we have tax in our transaction journal later on. To add the tax codes, just click new. Click new. And then we have PPN here, the tax code, and the description is value added tax. Value added tax. And the tax type is the sales tax, all right? Or you can add itself the value added tax. And the rate is 10%. Here, the link account that I explained before, link account for tax collected when we have the PPN transaction, and link account for tax paid when we have the transaction with the PPN. We can connect it, we can link it. We have some, the VAT collected, and the VAT paid. Whenever the transaction journal that we have, when we use the PPN collected or the VAT collected or the VAT paid, they will link to these accounts. Then, okay. How to edit one of them? I think we have the import duty, right? We have one here. Rather than create the new one, just edit the existing one, right? Edit, and then type the tax code, BM1, VAT, BM1, and then tax type is import duty, and then the rate is 10%. That's it, the link account, of course, import duty payable. Click OK. And so on. You can type the next one. And the last one, the third, is job. Let's see how to open the jobs. List and jobs. Okay. The function of this form is to create master database of jobs or projects. If the company has some projects from customers and want to know the profit and loss of the project, we have to categorize every single transaction journal by choosing the job. Okay. Now we want to create the job. Click new button. There are two types or position in job, which are header and detail. This position is to group the type of job. Okay. We have header for GAAR, architect services. So header and then GAAR and the name is architect services. All right, then click new. We have another one for the detail of this header, the GB detail job, GB01, sub job of GR, right? And the name is building picture. Building picture. Okay. Then if you want to type other fields, you can do that. After that, you can click OK. In the job, you also can add the budget here. For example, click the building picture and then you can type the project budgets. Okay, after we've done creating everything that we want to create for the first setup company, we have to backup the file first. How to backup the file of the company? We can go to the file and then backup. All right. Here, because we just have some information, just backup company file only. And check company file for errors. Okay, no errors were found in your company file. Click OK. So here, the name of the folder is already made. So just save it. But if you want to name it into another name, it's okay as well. And how to restore the backup then? You can go to file and restore. Your last backup was earlier. Do you wish to backup at this time? No. You want to restore. Click the one that we have before for the backup and then open and save. Save it here. Save it, the name, and then OK. Open it. And then choose. We have three options here. Just choose the second option. I want to activate my company file letter and then continue. All right, that's all for the video. We have done setting up our first company file and we will see you on the next video. Thank you for watching this video. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.